very chaotic year. A lot of it's been bad, a couple things pretty good, but who gives a shit? I graduated college. Yes! May 14th, 2022 was the day I graduated college, Connor Moffitt, with a degree in broadcast production. The day was actually... The day was pretty good. I saw everyone I knew from my entire college, which was lovely. There were people passing out in the stands, just everyone just exhausted, just dying. It was 9 a.m, and that's what it kind of felt like leading up to this day. We finally got here, so let's just get the diploma and get the fuck out. I mean, and that's what happened. I got out, and I might have cracked open a few drinks, you know what I mean? Drank some, I don't even... I don't know. Gabe had a drink called the Garfield. I don't know. I'm with you in the background. Whenever I fall. Telling your brothers. Say you're gone. Put your sister on the phone. The idea and routine of school is so conditioned into our minds as kids, so to have the rest of your life being to do whatever the fuck you want is a little scary. And I know this isn't like fucking Rick and Morty, like, crazy stuff, but either way, it's been something that I've been thinking about for the better part of this year, where I feel like I'm panicking to lay the groundwork down of my life in my 20s so I don't have anything to regret when I decide to bring more responsibility into my life, like cool cars and fucking cool stuff. Endings are also just weird in general. Having to sit with the idea that you're never gonna do something or experience it ever
again.
And yeah, I made some good memories in college and I made some shitty ones too. And it's comfortable to feel like those memories or the opportunity to recreate those memories are just a text away. On top of that, you have scandalized. It's a little confusing and unmotivating to make a video like this just because I'm forced to come to terms and rethink about all the shit that has happened to me in the past year or two. For the first time in my life, I'm ready to forget the rest. I'm ready to move past whatever the fuck happened during my time
in academia.
But it's hard and sad to reconcile with those memories you made, good or bad. I'm a completely different version of who I was in high school or college.
Alright, what is going on, guys? In fact, your boy Glenn Mavi here, and today we are doing a Minecraft survival video, and I did a little bit of off-camera work. I made a crafting table and a chest so I could
Jeez, Rick and Mortis want you to smash the like button!
Today we're gonna be talking about Rick and Morty. I guess what I'm trying to say is that I've had to sit with myself in a way that I've never had to before. I don't have something to work on at 9 p.m. for something that's due at 11 a.m. in the morning the next day. And for a person that needs some kind of carrot on a stick to keep chasing, it was a strange feeling to end the chase that was school. And I've been in that chase of my whole life. Part of it goes back to, you know, what I was saying before. You know, after 5 p.m. hits, I'm off the clock. It's just me and my cock. You know what I mean? I'm just fucking... No one is telling you to do anything. You have to be accountable for what you decide to do with your time. No professor or anyone is going to tell you what to do to make what you want in your life happen. It's you that has to do it. It's oddly liberating and just fucking soul-crushing and demoralizing at the same time. The feeling of liberation comes from what just the possibilities are and the potential of what you can do with that freedom. And that claustrophobic feeling comes from what you have to bring out of yourself to rise to that occasion. Being confident in knowing what you want is scary, but like anything, you can get better at expressing and adapting that to the skill set of your character.
Listen, step out, don't pre-up, cause that's my goodums. I gripped on two, so I cheated, I think that I shouldn't, but no, I should've. The CID can't chat to me.
Routine is comfort, whether it be good or bad. I think that's why a lot of people today, and for a long time now, are so fixated on nostalgia for what high school or even some degree of college is. It's nice to have a routine or schedule that someone made for you, whether it be parents, professors, or some higher form of authority. There are rules to the routine and lifestyle in school, like most things, but the stakes are so low to where it doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things. Like, say, I don't know, if you were to do like a parking lot takeover, or like taking over, a Sears or like a Dick's Sporting Goods or something. Anyway, it's exciting to rebel against a set of rules or deviate from routine. You get a sense of, you know, feeling naughty, a sense of being a bad guy, like you're some sort of fucking weird freak or creature or something. And once you get past that stage of your life, what is there to rebel against? You know, like your gas bill.
Or like the fucking, or the government, I don't know.
I have no idea what I said in this video, but keep an open mind. Meet new people. Be confident in yourself. You aren't gonna get what you want if you aren't confident in yourself and what you believe in and what you want. I truly believe that. Now, don't be fucking stupid about it. So that's why I'm on the path of like fucking owning my own life and like fucking everything in like my spiritual and financial path. What'd you learn this year? Type it down in the comments. No, I don't know. I'm just fucking ready for something new.
Yeah, turn me up a little, daddy. I can't hear myself, lordy. Baklava, charming, you know it's him. Prince Charming, the Dolphins, once again.